So Excel is releasing an amazing set of functions, which are going to be map, by row, by column, reduce. So if you're familiar with array methods in programming languages like JavaScript, Python, etc., you should have a pretty good idea of what these actually do. Otherwise, they could be a little complicated to understand at first. So generally, what these functions are going to allow you to do is to convert anything that was not possible to convert to an array function to an array function. So let's do an example of that. For example, if we have an AND function in our spreadsheet, if I'm trying to check for multiple conditions, so let's say I want to make sure that this sales amount is greater than 7,000, comma, and at the same time, I want to make sure that cost of goods sold is greater than 4,000. So if I did that, close parentheses, hit enter, I could drag this formula down and see we'll get our trues and falses. So like we have a true here when both conditions are met, we have another true here, etc. Maybe one more. Now the problem with this function is that you cannot really use AND as an array function. So I couldn't just go here and do G2 colon G17 and then also F2 colon F17 and hit enter and get this to populate all of these results. We can use some trickery to make it happen with some math calculations and so, but not with AND function. So now using this array methods, this will actually be possible. So let me just keep this formula like this. So let me try to now convert this to an array formula. To be able to actually understand what I'm doing in this video, it's helpful if you have some experience with Lambda function. I'm gonna link to that video in video description so you can check that out if you haven't yet. Otherwise, we're gonna continue here. So what I'm gonna start doing, I'm gonna use map function. And with map function, we're gonna give it one or more arrays as our first argument. So for example, I could grab this first column right here. That's gonna be my first array. Then I'm gonna do a comma. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select the second column, which is my cost, comma again. As a third argument, we're gonna use lambda function. Now, you could use a single array if you wanted to. You could use multiple arrays if you want to. So there's really no limit how many. Right now, because I'm gonna work with these two columns, I have those two columns selected. So once you have your data, now you can follow that by a lambda function. So lambda function here is going to accept parameters. And the way it's going to work, you're going to pass arguments from these two arrays that you've defined. Since I have two of them, I'm gonna have two arguments. You can call these arguments anything you want. So for example, in this case, I could call the first one sales, comma, and the second one cost, like this. These are just names, so you could have just done A, comma, B if you wanted to. I'm gonna do another comma here. Let me just move right a little bit. And now I'm gonna follow that by the actual formula I want to use. So if you remember that AND function, so let me just comment this for a second, like this. This is that AND function. I'm gonna copy that formula without that equal sign, hit escape. Go back to this formula. Let me remove this comment here. And I'm gonna follow this comma by that formula. I'm gonna paste that formula here. Let's move this out of the way. And then I'm gonna go ahead and close parentheses for that lambda function at this point, and another parentheses for my map function. So we're almost done here. There's only one problem here. This G2 is no longer gonna be G2 in this lambda function. So if you remember, this G2 used to refer to this line item in our sales column. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use this variable that I've defined here in this lambda function instead. So I'm gonna do sales, and then this one, I'm gonna replace with this variable here. So essentially what's happening here, we give it two arrays, and after that, what's gonna happen in our lambda function, each row in the first array, this one, is gonna become this variable, and each row in our second array here is gonna become our second variable. So at this point, the sales is going to refer to each row from our sales column, and cost will refer to each row from our cost of goods sold column. And then we can use those variables here in our actual calculation. So at this point, if I hit enter, now that should just make it an array formula. See, I got my trues where they should be. So that's our map function. Basically, it runs through an array, and each time within your Lambda function, it's gonna give you one of the rows within that array. Now, this is true so long as your array is a single column. As you can see, I did refer to each column as a single column, but you could also refer to something like this. So at this point, if you do this, I'm just gonna use one array in this case. You need to follow that with your Lambda function. So now if I use some sort of variable, I'm just gonna call it X this time. This will now loop through every single cell within this array. So basically every single cell within these two columns and apply that function to that. So let's check if that X is greater than 2000. So at this point, if I close Lambda function and map, hit enter, because we have two column results, it's basically gonna go through every single value here and check if they are actually above 2000. And if they are, it's gonna give us trues. See, these are trues because these are above 2000. These two are not, so we're gonna get falses for those. And then the same thing is gonna happen with this column. So we're gonna check every single value, like this one is not above 2000, so we get a false here. So another great thing about this map function is when you get this Lambda parameter here, you get a reference instead of getting just a value, which is awesome because we can now do things that otherwise would be impossible to do. So let's do an example with this running total. So let's say I'm trying to create an array function that's gonna give me a running total. If you want to do a regular running total function, you would have done equal sum, open parentheses, and then I would grab the cell and do another colon, another B2, close parentheses, like this. And then to be able to keep this reference locked, I would have done a dollar sign for that row 2. And at this point, if I drag this formula down, let's make this a little bigger. We're gonna get our running total. Essentially here, we just get this one cell. Then when we go to the next row, because our first reference is locked, we get that first row 2, and then we get up to this row. And we get the total of these two. Then we get the total of these 3, then 4, then 5, and so on. Now let's try to convert this using that map function to an array function. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm gonna do map, open parentheses. So my array this time is going to be this entire range. So now I'm gonna do a comma and follow that by a Lambda function. And here we're gonna get a parameter, which is basically each row from this sales amount. Let's just call it R for now. Comma, now I have to do that calculation. Now, if you remember, my formula was sum B2 colon B2, and then I had this dollar sign for this. Then I'm gonna close parentheses again, and close parentheses one more time for this map function. Now we need to use this R in a creative way to make this work. Now, right now it's not going to, I'm gonna hit enter. Now, if you remember what we used to do, this B2 cell was stuck to this cell. But if I go to these other rows, you'll see the second part of this range keeps changing to our current row. So this goes to B3, then this goes to B4. So it goes to our current row every time, like this. So this part doesn't change, this one does right here. So for that reason, I'm gonna go to this formula. This is the part that used to change to our current row. And if you remember, this R is our current row. It's not the value of the current row, it's a reference, meaning I could just do this, R. So with this, if I hit enter, we got our array formula, just like that. So we have one array formula that gives us that running total. That's amazing. Let me give you an example of this BYROW function too. Map, as you remember, it goes through each value individually, one by one, and it maps through all of the values. But what if we want to do something like this? Let's say we have these numbers right here, these scores, and we're trying to get the maximum of each row. For example, if I do max function and select these, the maximum of that row is going to be 8. And then I want to be able to drag this down. 9, 4, see, each row, we get the max of that. Now, in this case, when we do this max calculation, we do it over entire row in this array, not individual cells separately, but the whole row. Then it goes to the next row, next row, next row. We apply the same max function to it. So this is where using that by row is going to help you. So with this function, when you provide an array like this, comma, then you follow by that lambda function. And in this lambda function, whatever parameter you provide is going to refer to this entire row. So first time it's going to be first row, then second row, then third row. So for now, I'm going to call it R for row, I guess, comma. And then I'm going to do the actual calculation. So if you remember, my formula was max, and it used to refer to this range. I'm going to close parentheses again, close parentheses one more time to get to this parentheses. So now this can be replaced with this R, which every time is going to be one of these rows. So if I do R right there, hit enter, we get our array formula just like that, using this by row function. And I can delete this now, and it just works. Now let's do an example of by column too. So let's say here, I would like to get the average of each one of these columns. So regularly, I would do average, open parentheses, select this column, like that, enter. See, that gives me this. Then I can drag this formula right to get the average for each column. So now if you want to do this with an array formula, then you can use that by column function. So the difference between by row and by column is that by row will basically map through your array row by row, and by column will map through your array column by column. So let's do an example right here. I'm going to do equals by COL. That's our function. Now I'm going to refer to this whole range. Now within this range, because we use by column, it's going to go first column, second column, third column, fourth column. So now I can do a comma here, and I can follow this by my lambda function. For this, I'm going to call it COL for each column, comma. And then basically that COL is going to become every time one of these columns. So what we're going to do here, we're going to use that average function again. And I used to just select this column here, but now we can use this variable, COL, which should refer to each column. So we'll take that, close parentheses again, close parentheses one more time to basically close this one. And if I hit enter, see, I get one formula that fills the whole array going right, and we got our averages. So there you have it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.